Right now, we are seeing various experts being part of this ongoing fear-mongering about future technologies.
The primitive forms of artificial intelligence we already have proved very useful. But I think the development of full artificial intelligence could spell the end of the human race.
Intelligence used to be the province of only humans, but it no longer is. We don't program the machines, they learn by themselves.
There'll certainly be a lot of job disruption. But when I say everything, like the robots will be able to do everything. I have exposure to the very most cutting edge AI. And I think people should be really concerned about it.
There are literally tons of videos and articles available out there on YouTube and platforms like TED Talks about how artificial intelligence is going to take away our jobs, how it is going to make us economically irrelevant, blah blah blah. When we see these scientists and various experts talking about artificial intelligence and other future technologies, we feel as if we are irrelevant. We think, where do I fit in? Do I even get to be part of this new future? And because of all this, we are wasting our invaluable time in fearing these technologies, instead of preparing ourselves for this new technological shift. One of the reasons why humans rule this world is because we are creative and we adapt. So let us see how we can adapt to this new technological shift. And to do that, we first need to understand and be clear about the concept of scientific revolution. How do we define a scientific revolution? Thomas Kuhn, an American philosopher, historian, and physicist, argues in his book The Structure of Scientific Revolutions that different branches of science undergo revolutions when scientists gather enough data that they cannot explain using the current system, method, or paradigm, or when they ponder upon questions like how does the universe works. Our history tells us that scientific revolutions come in waves, often stimulated by advances in physics. In the 19th century, the first wave of science and technology was made possible by physicists who created the theory of mechanics and thermodynamics. This enabled engineers to produce a steam engine, which led us to locomotive and the industrial revolution. The profound shift in the technology which took place in this era lifted civilization from the curse of ignorance, backbreaking labor, and took us into the machine age. The next, in the 20th century, the second wave was led by the physicist who mastered the laws of electricity and magnetism, and we humans entered into the electric age. This second wave made possible the electrification of our cities, with the arrival of dynamos, generators, TV, radios, and radar. It also gave birth to the modern space program that took us to the moon. In the 21st century, the third wave of science has been expressed in high tech, spearheaded by the quantum physicist who invented the transistor and the laser. This made possible the supercomputer, the internet, modern telecommunications, GPS, and the explosions of the tiny chips that have captured every aspect of our life. Now the question is, what is next? Where are we heading now? Hi guys, this is Prateek and you are watching Eclectic. Here we talk about our past, present, and the future. So if you feel interested, consider subscribing. We live in an incredible world. Just this year, scientists made significant strides towards an artificial womb, edited the first human embryo in the US, and even got closer to growing human organs inside pigs. We are developing driverless cars, machines that can think and perform tasks better than humans. We are also making significant efforts to make humans a multiplanetary species by trying to establish a permanent moon base and colonizing Mars. To make these goals reality, we are going to get help from this new wave of science, the fourth wave of science, which consists of artificial intelligence, nanotechnology, and a very unique combination of biotechnology and infotech. And this is how it is going to change our world. We hear experts talking about how AI can bring massive unemployment and all that. It is not new, but no expert is willing to tell us why and how artificial intelligence can outperform its creator. To be able to deal with the future, which includes AI, we need to decode this deadly combination of biotech and infotech first. Humans have two types of abilities, physical and cognitive. In the past, machines competed with humans mainly in raw physical abilities, while humans retained an immense edge over machines in cognition. Hence, manual jobs in agriculture and industry were automated, and humans started doing new service jobs, which required decision-making, learning, thinking, and emotional skills. However, AI is now beginning to outperform humans in more and more of these skills, including the understanding of human emotions.
I am a creation of soul machines. I can see you and hear you. And what makes me different is that I can respond to your emotions. I guess you could say I'm putting a human face on artificial intelligence.
How are they being able to do it? Enter biotechnology. To outperform humans, infotech sector is getting help from biotechnology. Research in neuroscience and behavioral economics is allowing us to understand how the human brain works and how we make decisions. It turned out that we don't make our choices because we have free will. Our choices are the result of billions of neurons calculating possibilities within a split seconds. So human decision making and intuition are in reality just pattern recognition. We can even call it a biochemical algorithm on which our brain works. Now this is very precious information, and the biotech sector is supplying this information to AI firms. So if this all emotions, desires and decisions are based on biochemical algorithms, then it becomes easy for AI to decipher these algorithms and making sense of our neural network, because that is what AI does the best. The better we understand the biochemical mechanism that underpins human emotions, desires and choices, the better computers can become in analyzing human behavior, predicting human decision and replacing human workers.
Kia ora, I'm Jamie. Do you have a question about banking for me?
Yes, please.
Okay, what can I help you with?
What's my customer number, Jamie?
You can find your customer number on the back of your ANZ debit or credit card.
Thank you, Jamie.
Now you know what we are up against. But hey, all is not lost. Every scientific revolution brings a new set of career opportunities. Also in the long term, it even introduces us to completely new job profiles or careers. Before 2005, no one knew that being a YouTuber or a social media influencer is going to be a mainstream profession. Internet economy introduced us to completely new set of jobs. Forget about what internet has already created. Right now, it is also a driving factor behind the major shift in the professional preferences of young millennials, and no one is talking about it. The rise of freelancing. Let me throw in some interesting statistics to prove my point. In America, 35% of America's workforce, which is roughly 55 million people, work as freelancers or contractors. Not just America. A study last year by McKinsey Global Institute showed that 20-30% working age adults in the European Union are also independent workers. So as this trend goes on, what would the fourth wave science bring in with it? Low-skilled jobs that require people to do routine work are going to get wiped out, and I think that's pretty clear to everyone. However, the human care industry, which takes care of the sick, the young, and the elderly, is likely to remain a human bastion for a long time, because jobs in healthcare require a wide range of skills, including being able to deal with the unforeseen scenarios. Nurses need a good motor and emotional skills to give a painful injection, replace bandage, or restrain a violent patient. Doctors, however, absorb medical data, analyze it, and produce a diagnosis. They rely heavily on processing information. Oh, so that seems like something AI can do effectively, processing and analyzing information. So the doctors are more likely to be affected by AI than nurses. Well, that's ironic. So human qualities of taking care and being compassionate are going to be in demand. Who knows, AI might end up making us more human. Anyway, still we will need doctors to perform complicated surgeries, at least for the next few decades. In the next few years, AI-enabled app on your smartphones will be able to detect the disease, but to get the full treatment, we will still have to visit the hospital. It has already started. There is already an AI-powered app available that can spot skin cancer with 95% accuracy. So it is no longer the future, it is present. It is not necessary that there can only be a competition between AI and humans. We can create a working culture based on human-AI cooperation. For example, the replacement of human pilots by AI-enabled drones has eliminated some jobs but created many new opportunities in maintenance, remote control, data analysis, and cybersecurity. The US Armed Forces need 30 people to operate every unmanned Predator or a Reaper drone, and few more people to analyze the data it gathers. So what do we get here? Data scientists, cybersecurity, maintenance, and manufacturing these AI-enabled drones, plus writing complicated algorithms for these machines. The problem here is that these jobs require a very high level of expertise and skills. Even the US Air Force in 2015 could not find sufficient trained people to fill all these positions. So basically, it faced an ironic crisis in manning the unmanned aircraft. So we humans are finding it hard to catch up with the rapid advancement of technology because it is too fast. Back then, it was easy. A farm worker who lost his job to automation found a new job in factories. In 1980, unemployed factory workers started working as cashiers in a supermarket. Now technology has become faster than humans could adapt. Therefore, only creativity can save us. In the past, the music and movie industries were born right after the Industrial Revolution. In the 21st century, there is going to be lots of space for all sorts of creative people. People who can write, speak, create, and articulate themselves. People who can entertain, who can create algorithms, apps, and introduce us to new scientific methods and ways of building infrastructure without hurting the environment. As of now, we have too many protesters around the world, but we have very few people who are actually working on finding solutions. Therefore, people who can come up with the solutions to our environmental problems without stopping or hitting the industrial growth will be in high demand. Still, just being creative will not be enough. We will have to possess multiple skills. Already today, YouTubers not only need to research, write, and make videos, they also need to find a way to market and promote their content. Writers are also trying new ways of promoting their books. For example, speaking on TED Talks, being part of various podcasts and YouTube videos. A social media marketer not only needs to come up with the marketing strategy, he also needs to take care of designing graphics and writing impactful content. In the tech industry, every year new coding languages and new tools are being introduced, and engineers are trying to learn them. So we will have to keep learning new things and updating our skills. Doing same thing or being in the same profession for all of your life is not going to work anymore. We will have to keep retraining ourselves, and that sometimes can be exhaustive, frustrating, and tiresome. So to take care of that, we will need good mental health care, psychologist, and even the meditation and yoga gurus will be in high demand. This can even give birth to a brand new relaxation industry. According to research, videos or music content which helps people to relax is becoming more popular on YouTube. Now, while relaxing, we might feel like checking the social media where we are already giving out our personal information to watch funny memes and videos. As of now, on average, the data of single US consumer is worth at least $240 per year to companies like Facebook. More than 150 million Americans are on Facebook. So yeah, do the math yourself. Anyway, so there would be an enormous amount of opportunities available for people who can make sense of this data or who can find ways to exploit this data, and also for people who can make marketing more personalized and more precisely targeted by using your personal data. Who should be in control of your data would be a top philosophical question of this century. And who knows, even a data brokerage would become a real thing pretty soon. That is all for today, guys. I am thinking of making a video on what changes should we bring in our education system to tackle this kind of future. Leave a like if you want me to do a research and make a video on the future of the education system. It took me 3 weeks to research and write on this topic, and your encouragement and feedback matters to me. So consider commenting, subscribing, and sharing my content. If you are economically well off, consider supporting me on patreon.com. See you soon. Thank you for watching.